hearts always hunger for. Oh, our hearts always hunger for.
Thank you for that opening song and getting ready to have Hope Sound Bible College Chapel Choir or choir here this evening. So glad they're able to make it all the way from 11298 Southeast Gomez. Traveling mercies have been granted, and they are here, each and every one, and we're so glad that they are here. As I was thinking about this service tonight, I was thinking, you know, all throughout Scripture in the Old Testament, Many times we find that instruments were used, songs were used to bring encouragement and healing and help to a lot of troubled souls. And I'm just convinced that as I look across this crowd, there's just several people, I am sure, that are going through some difficult times and facing some pretty big mountains in their lives and perhaps maybe just a tad bit discouraged. You don't have to admit it, but maybe you are. But I'm glad that in a time like this, as the musicians are playing and the instruments are in tune and the singers are singing, God wants to use a time just like this to use music and song to turn our eyes to Jesus and focus on Him and bring encouragement to our hearts and lives. And I believe that if we will do more than just come and sit like a bump on a log, we all are capable of doing that. You're doing it now. But if you will come with the purpose of opening our hearts and worshiping the Lord when they are singing songs about our good God and His grace and His mercy, if we'll just let our hearts swell with praise and worship, I'm convinced that we will leave this place tonight saying, man, it has surely been good to be in God's house worshiping the King of Kings and Lord of Lords. And so we're glad that you're here. We're glad the choir's here. We know God is here, and He wants to make Himself known to us. So let's be participants. So we're going to go ahead and give this a shot. Everybody raise your hand. Everybody say amen.
Amen.
Thank the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Cry. I believe if we'll just put ourselves in the service, God will come and meet with us. Amen. Dear Heavenly Father, we love you. We thank you. We praise you for your goodness. And we're asking that in this time that we have together tonight, that we not look at it just as a performance, but Lord, it's a time to engage in worship and praise and thanksgiving as the students are ministering through song and music. And God, as you would meet with us and as you would help us, we'll thank you and praise you for all that you have done and what you're doing for us. In Jesus' name, we ask these things. Amen. Dr. Ryder's coming to lead us in a song or so, and then we're going to enjoy a time of worship together through music.
Join me as we sing, Blessed Assurance, Jesus is Mine.
Blessed assurance, Jesus is mine. Oh, what a foretaste of glory divine. Heir of salvation, purchase of God, born of his spirit, washed in his blood. This is my story, this is my song, praising my Savior. Savior all the day long. This is my story, this is my song, praising my Savior all the day long. Perfect submission, perfect delight, visions of rapture.
The one. I'm so glad this time to testify of my Lord. I'm serving a great promise-keeping God. Though ages can pass by, time changes, men can change, creation can change, but God never changes a time. Amen. He is the God who keeps his promise. And the promise that he kept and fulfilled is the time we are coming towards, which is Easter. It was way back in the Old Testament, God promised, but it fulfilled in my time, and now I'm so glad that I've experienced the true meaning of Easter in my life. Amen. I am the product of what Christ did on the cross. Yes. I was lost in a Christian family. I was raised up by my uncle who's a pastor, but I was lost. And I didn't get to know the plan of salvation in my life. Oh, the redemptive power of the blood of Jesus works in man's life. I didn't know that in my life. And I was just hiding away in the presence of my parents because I know that they're going to belt me after all if I don't go for Sunday school, if I don't go to church. So that's why I was attending church. But I did not realize it in my life. But there came a time when I realized the true plan of salvation in my life. The promise which God planned some years way back, it happened in my life. I felt it in my life that time. And now I want to look after it, and I want to serve, and I want to be the Lord's servant. Even though life will seem to be there is no hope. Sometimes I can go down the valley, sometimes I can come up the mountain. But I know that the faithful God, the promise-keeping God is there. The God who led Moses, the God who led Miriam, the God who appointed David to be the king, that's the same God is now in my time. So I want to live for that God, and I want to serve him, and I want to do whatever he wants me to do. I am just his available vessel. Here I am. As the saying goes, any of these products we see, any of the resources we can use on this side of earth, they say this is the product of this place, and that place. But I am the product of Calvary. So I want to leave that and pass it on to the others. So that will lead us to the next song, the same God. So cast our burdens to that God.
Love endures through generations. the shepherd boy courageous. I may not face Goliath, but I got my own giants. Oh God, my God, I need you. Oh God, my God, I need you now. How I need you now. Oh rock, oh rock of ages, I'm standing on your faithfulness. On your
everyone. There's nothing good in me that I can say with you all tonight. In my life, I have so many scars of sin. And there's nothing good that I have done which has attracted God to come into my life. All I can testify and all I can say tonight is I can praise what Jesus Christ has done upon the cross of Calvary. He has done it all for me. There's nothing that I can do that he has left it for me. And tonight, if God was a man, I didn't think he should accept me because I fall many times in my life. If he wasn't that loving God as he is, I didn't think I should have stand here right now. Because I have failed so many promises that I have said I will keep those promises, but yet I have broken those promises in my lifetime. But tonight, it is because of his love and his grace, here I am tonight. And there's nothing that I can boast about tonight. As we have sang the congregational song this night, all I have to tell you tonight, the story that I have in my whole life that I'm going to say in my life, that sometimes if God give me, is I will tell the story of wonders he has done up on the cross of Calvary, and that is the only story that I have in my life. To God be the glory.
Thank you. Today's Palm Sunday, in a week's time, we'll be celebrating Easter. But a few days prior to Easter, Jesus walked down a road carrying a heavy cross, carrying my sin and my guilt. And then he walked down that road up on a hill, and he died on a cross. But on that cross, he settled a debt that I owed. He paid the debt for me and settled it. And then a few days later, on Easter Sunday, he rose from the grave, conquering sin and hell, and giving me eternal life if I choose to follow him. I'm so thankful tonight that I've chosen to follow him in everything that I do. And I'm so thankful tonight for the power of the cross.
Of the cross, Christ became I'm thankful that Jesus Christ came to this earth and he died on the cross for our sins, aren't you? You know, I was thinking this evening as the choir was singing, if Jesus had not come, if he had not come, how different that would be for all of us here this evening. We would be without hope. We would all be condemned to a devil's hell. There would just be no point in life at all. But I'm so glad that Jesus Christ came to this earth and he died on the cross for you and for me. He took our place. We should have been the ones that hung on that cross, but he took our place. He was our substitute. He gave his life willingly so that you and I could have life, and we could have it abundantly, and we could have freedom, and we could have hope, and we could have a relationship with him. And I'm glad this evening that Jesus Christ is my Savior. And I trust that that's your testimony tonight as well, that you know him more than just a historical figure. You know him more than just a Bible story, but you know him as a reality in your heart and life, that Jesus Christ has come in and he has changed you from the person that you once were, the sin that once had you bound. He set you free from that. And tonight you live in joy and freedom and liberty, knowing that your sins are forgiven and that you have him in your life. And one of these days, you'll spend forever in eternity with him, praising him and thanking him for the glorious work of redemption that he's done in your life. And I trust that there's just something this evening, as you've heard these young people sing, and they're singing from their hearts tonight, that there's something within you that also just wells up and says, I want to give God praise for what he has done for me, for the change that he's made in my life. I'm not the person I once was, because Jesus Christ has came and he's set me free. Praise his name. Well, thank you so much for being here this evening. And we certainly are enjoying God's presence that's just meeting with us here in a special way. We thank the choir for just these great reminders of the goodness of God and his faithfulness to us across the ages. And I know that many of you are able to testify with these songs as well tonight, and we thank the Lord for that. I just want to give you just a little brief update as to what's happening at Hope Sound Bible College. And we certainly do thank so much of Hope Sound Bible Church allowing us this opportunity tonight to share in music and testimony of what God's doing. And we are excited about, as we look towards our next school year, there's a lot of great things currently happening. God has been so good to us. He's met and supplied so many different needs, and we're rejoicing in how he's been meeting with us on a regular basis in our chapel services. God's presence has been so near, and we give God praise for how he's just giving victory after victory after victory in our students' lives, and we thank him for that. We also thank him for how he's providing for us financially. You know, it takes a lot of money to run an organization like a Bible college, and I know for some people they feel like it's just a bottomless pit, that no matter how much you give, the Bible college is always going to be asking for money. And I do understand that there's a little bit of truth to that as far as we're always going to need money, but it's really an investment in the lives of young people and the next generation of Christian leaders. And the students that we're training, as they graduate from our halls, they're going to go out into this world and they're going to make a difference for Jesus Christ. And that's our prayer. And as we have been kind of thinking a little bit more about our motto, and I was talking with Brother Jim Olson, and he was sharing with me how the motto kind of came about. Kind of interesting story, and if you'd like to know the whole story, you should talk to him a little bit about that sometime. But knowing Christ and making him known, that's what Hope Sound Bible College is. That's our motto, and that's what we're about. And we're doing our best to train students with excellence. And we have a great, great lineup of professors who pour into our students on a daily basis, inside the classroom, outside the classroom, serving as mentors and discipling. And our students, I believe, really are going to graduate from these halls, and they can testify that they really, really know Christ. They know him as a reality for themselves. But one of the things that, as we've been kind of thinking about the future, we've thought, you know, there's maybe some ways that we could do a little bit better at making him known and helping our students as they are studying right here, not to wait until they graduate to make Christ known, but ways that they can make Christ known right now. And so as we look towards next semester in the fall, we're going to begin a trade program, a trade school right here on our campus. And I want to thank Brother Frank Vaughn for helping spearhead that. And we're going to be offering a welding trade right here on the campus. And some of you will have the opportunity to participate in that. And we're looking for ways to just give practical tools for our students to be able to share Christ. And as many of you know, if you're called to ministry, sometimes, even though it may be a full-time call, it may not have a full-time pay that's associated with that. And so we believe that a trade such as welding, and then, Lord willing, in the future, we'll get into some of the other trades, being able to offer those as well, machining and HVAC and carpentry, electrical and plumbing, and even maybe culinary, who knows. But we're looking into all these different options to just give tools that can equip our students to help them be better prepared to share the gospel in unique ways, in ways perhaps that we wouldn't traditionally think of. And so, of course, a welding degree or a welding certification pairs up very nicely with for a ministerial student who's studying to preach the gospel. And he can go to a church, and many churches are not able to pay them full-time pay. But because of this, they'll be able to weld on the side and also pastor a church. And then, of course, it pairs up very nicely with missions as well, as they'll be able to go wherever God would call them. And then there's some people that we believe that God is perhaps just calling them to be a layman in the church, and that is okay. God called laymen in the church is some of the best people that you could possibly have. Not everybody's called to be a pastor, and most of you here tonight don't have that calling, and that's okay. We need some God-called laymen, like a welder perhaps, who will say, you know what, I'm going to weld, and I'm going to tithe, and I'm going to teach Sunday school, and I'm willing to serve on the board, and I'm going to support my pastor. And when they call for an outreach day, I'm going to go out and I'm going to knock on doors and I'm going to support my pastor. And when there's people up at the altar praying around the altar, I'm going to come up and I'm going to pray around those people. And that's kind of the goal that we're endeavoring to just equip our students with practical tools that they can go out and they can make Christ known. So we would ask just an interest in your prayers, as we'll be going on choir tour here this week, later on this week, traveling several hundreds of miles, that God's presence would just be with us as we travel. But we're also asking that you would just help us to pray and ask what God would have you to give in support of the college, that we would just we're doing our best to make Christ known. And if that's something that resonates in your heart, we would ask that you would just consider giving in the offering here tonight. Pastor Matt's coming at this time to receive the offering tonight. And thank you again, Pastor Matt and the pastoral staff and all of you here at Hope Sound Bible Church for allowing us to be here this evening. God bless you.
Thank you, President Matt. And I'm not going to go down Harold's line now. Leave that for him. We just want to give you a couple of things before we take your money this evening. And we want to this is just a carryover of the volunteers who have helped us along the way. Pastor Stratton has put together two more slides of groups of volunteers who help us right here, Hope Sound Bible Church. If you are part of, we're wanting to satisfy Kendra Vion's itch as well. If you are here and you are part of a volunteer team for our youth department in any way, shape, or form, would you stand up for us tonight? I'm telling you, we don't have very many people working in our group. Kendra, where are you at? Stand up. Full time, understand. All right. Thank you so much, each and every one of you who helped in our youth department. And then also, one other slide is for all of the ones. This is very important. If you help in any way, Sunday school or during church services in our nursery, keeping it staffed so that we have a place for our children to go if need be, would you stand? Dear Sister Concio and Maddie and Kayla, thank you so very, 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 very much for all that you do to help us. And we know that we don't call every name out because we're going to miss some, and if we do, it makes no difference. But nonetheless, we want our volunteers to know that we are very appreciative of all they do to help us here. And just another reminder, as our ushers are coming at this time, that next Sunday evening, Pastor Glick and Sister Becky are going to be putting on or presenting or organizing, have been organizing, our Easter program. Unfortunately, it's going to be their last, and next Sunday is their last Sunday, and next Sunday evening they'll be having the Easter program. Looking forward to that time, and so just be here for that. You'll not be disappointed. Dear Heavenly Father, we thank you for your blessings, your goodness, and your help throughout this time already. We ask you to bless the gift and the giver. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Time. right. Good night, everyone. Tonight, I'm super excited. I'm excited that my Jesus is alive. He took my place. He died for me. He rose again. The tomb is empty. He's alive. He's alive. I have a story to tell the world that Jesus is alive. The tomb is empty. The stone was rolled away. I'm excited that Jesus died for my sin. He forgave me. He gave me freedom. The tomb is empty. The well was torn from the top to the bottom to set me free. I am free indeed. I don't fear man, but I fear God. I will tell the world that Jesus is my Savior. The world is lost, that I will tell the world Jesus Christ is able to break the chains of those who are bound. Because I was a sinner, bound by the sin, lost, hopeless. I don't know where I will find hope, but there was a time God convicted me, son, your life is not okay. You need to give your life to Jesus. That time, yes, I gave my life to you. He took over. He cleansed me. He gave me freedom. I have a testimony. I have a song because Jesus died for me. Amen. I have a song to sing. I have a testify because Calvary is not a hill. The old rugged cross. The cross is not emblem to me. Cross is not a lyrics to me. Cross is not a sign of a cemetery to me. But cross is power to me because it changed me. Amen. Changed me completely. I praise him tonight.
Holy Spirit, rain down, rain down. O Comforter and Friend, how we need your touch again. Holy Spirit, change our hearts as we stand on your word. Holy Spirit, rain down.
Holy Spirit, rain down, rain.
Open it wide over your church and The next song we're going to sing is called Nothing Ever Can, Nothing Ever Will. And there's one line in it that goes, nothing can stop God's, there's nothing on earth that can stop God's power. And I'm so thankful for that lyric because it reminds us that no matter what happens in this life, no matter what comes our way, God will always be on our side and his power is unstoppable.
When the story ends, we know Jesus will.
Well, I want to take this opportunity to thank God for who he is and what he's doing. I thank God, especially that he has sent his son. Without his death and the resurrection, I believe that a country boy like me, I won't have any hope. I would lost in some way, but I thank God. I thank God this evening because of Jesus Christ. His death has a meaning in my life. I was raised in a Christian home, but to be honest, I was not genuine. But in August 28, 2015, I met Jesus. And like a sun was shining in my life, as the sun rises, every little thing grows dim. Love of this world, anything grows dim when Jesus took place in my life. I thank God this evening that he gave us Jesus, and Jesus take my place. Amen. You know, sin was made sin for me, that I made righteous. I made receive the righteousness of God in him. Without Jesus, I have no hope. But I thank God this evening, especially for Jesus. Next song we will sing is about Jesus, the story of Jesus, the death and resurrection of Jesus. The empty tomb shows that we have hope.
Well, thank you so much for your kind attention tonight. This is our last song that we'll be singing. And this is a wonderful place to sing, because as we look across the crowd, there are so many faces that support and love and pray for these students on a daily basis. And that means the world to us as a faculty and a staff and administration, to have the support of a church family like this who loves us and loves our students. And so it's been just a real joy to minister and to sing to you tonight, to worship together. As we head out on the road next Saturday, I trust that you'll continue to pray for us. These are wonderful students. God has a call on their life for ministry, for vocation, for a lifetime of dedication, of service to him, and of becoming more and more conformed to the image of Jesus Christ. And as college professors and leaders, we have the opportunity to rub shoulders with them and get to know them and encourage them and spur them on. And so I trust that you'll pray for us as we go out on this choir tour. We're not going. We'll have a fun time. Don't you worry about that. But we're not going to have a fun time. We're going to spread the message of the gospel. And so pray for us as we go. We've been singing tonight, as many of you have probably caught a theme as we've been going through. We've been singing the story tonight, the story of how Jesus came and was born and lived a perfect life, died on the cross for our sins, and rose again the third day victorious to provide us with the access to victory. And so as we sing that story all around this nation over the next couple of weeks, as we sing that story, we have a desire as a choir that we would join in that story, that God's story that exists to bring him glory would become a part of our own story, that we would be grafted into God's big family, and that we would just be busy about our Father's business, accomplishing the purpose that he has for each one of us here, that we'll go on and expound to his glory alone. And so we're going to sing one more song, and it's a recap song. So I'm a teacher, so I know that sometimes you need a recap at the end of the lesson. But this will just remind you of where we've been and where we're going. Praise the Lord.
Thank you. stars into the night. He raised the mountains and carved the valleys. He reigns in righteousness and light. We sing the story of one so lowly, a humble king in manger lay. He walked among us and healed the broken, our Prince of Peace who came to save. Alleluia, all heaven sing, alleluia, to Christ our King, alleluia, again and again, alleluia, amen. Sing the story of blood and mercy, a sacrifice for sinners slain. But on that morning, just as he promised, the Lamb of God rose from the grave. Jesus, the Lamb rose from the grave. Hallelujah, all heaven sing, hallelujah.
God.
Amen.
Amen. There's a gentleman right over here. If there'd be some men, I'd like just to come and gather around him. And we're going to take some time and close in prayer tonight for each and every one of these choir members and Dr. Ryder as they head out and begin their first services, I believe, the 31st and go through the 7th. And I don't know who's picking out songs for IHC this year, but if you could somehow get a montage, if that's what it's supposed to be, of every one of those songs and make it about a 25, 30-minute time, it would be a wonderful thing. Did they not do a wonderful job in sharing the beautiful, beautiful message? Thank you so much. Great job. We appreciate each one of you. We love and pray for you, and we'll be praying for you as you go. Would you stand with us, and would you not just stand there, but lift your voices with us in praying for the choir as they travel, and that they would be effective as they minister in the many different places over the next few weeks. Dear Heavenly Father, we thank you and praise you tonight for what we have heard. Our heart has been encouraged and drawn to you, and God, we just thank you for who you are, and that Lord, from the very beginning of the song service, being reminded that, God, you are the same, and we stand on your faithfulness. You are unchanging, and even though the world seems to change and it seems as if times the devil is marshaling his host and making his boast, there is more with us, and be with him. We're on the winning side. You do win, and when it's all said and done, Lord, you are victorious. And what a wonderful reminder tonight as we go through life, and Lord, we feel the strains of the enemy in our life. We feel the pressures of the devil trying to get us to maybe cave or turn around. But Lord, we're so glad that as we keep our hand in yours, you change not, and we win, dear Lord, with you fighting with us and for us. Lord, we're thankful for that message tonight. And Lord, as they go about these next few days and weeks, dear Lord, would you just go with them? Give them the strength that they need. Lord, it gets tiresome as they have a long miles to travel and then getting set up and practicing, rehearsing, and then ministering and then doing it all over again. Lord, as the miles come and go and the weariness of body is there, we ask that you would just come and minister to their spirits, that, Lord, they would be able to be an encouragement night after night as they share this beautiful message in which we have heard this evening. Lord, go with them, be with them, protect them, and help them. Be with the one that is praying tonight. Lord, you know the need. You know the circumstance there, and listen, response to you. Lord, would you meet that need this very evening? And God, as you would help and as you would bless, dear Lord, give them protection as they travel. We'll be sure to thank you and praise you and give you glory, for you alone are worthy. We ask all of these things in Jesus' name. And all God's people said, amen. Before you leave, just two things. One of them, if you are helping with mail call, Andrea Sickler would like to have all of those cards and things no later than the 27th. So you can drop them off at the church office, or you can go over to the music office and make sure those things are there. So keep that in mind. And then, as we have been announcing, after this time together, we'll be meeting in the Schmuel Dining Center for those who are going to be part of that time of a farewell fellowship for the Glicks. Thank you so much for coming. God bless you. You're dismissed.